Thank you. To confuse this animal, the Giganotosaurus, with the T-Rex. They look similar, act similar, and both have that eat everything within their field of vision thing working for them. This dinosaur is also fast. Bottom line, if you find yourself running from this biggie, you've already made a fatal mistake.
Yeah. here. It's an Amargasaurus, according to the paperwork I have in front of me. Another interesting factoid. Its long neck meant it probably liked to feed on the taller branches of trees and such. At least that's what it says. Guess we'll find out, huh?
I'm Dr. Kajal Dua, and while you're keeping an eye on the dinosaurs, I'll be keeping an eye on you. There is an ironically tragic quality to seeing a dinosaur that has been brought back from the dead die. But death has unfortunately come for one of our animals. Clear the carcass from the enclosure before it can spread disease.
Thank you.
Our goal at the park is to keep guest count to the maximum and the body count to a minimum. George Lambert is a man tasked with that, task. Mr. Lambert?
There was a lot of controversy about dinosaurs being the ancestors of modern-day birds before this one was introduced into the park. It's an Archaeornithomimus. I think it puts some of those arguments to rest.
They call this the Ankylosaurus. I call it an armored ball of walking, breathing trouble. Still, some might call it charming, amusing, delightful. Each to their own. Thank you.
Welcome to your future and our past. I'm Claire Deering. I used to be management until things went awry. Now I'm more of an advocate. John Hammond wanted a world with dinosaurs, and I want us to take care of them. I hope you do as well. Talk about the opposite of subtle, and I don't mean Owen. No, this is the Chasmosaurus. It has dynamic coloring and these large openings, called fenestrae, in a frill that rises above its head. This is a dinosaur that says, "Look at me." So, maybe a little like Owen.
This entire operation started with a dream that was realized through science. For that, we can thank Dr. Henry Wu.
We know this animal's primary habitat was the ancient primordial forest that once covered this planet. It's called Dryosaurus. Before our research, there was no information on adult specimens of this dinosaur. We only had the fossilized record of juveniles. But now, that's all changed.
Come on.